Well, Associate Professor Jean Bogais has been closely watching events unfold in France. He's a sociologist at the University of Sydney. Thanks again for joining us. Now, the right says they're victims of a dishonest alliance that's blocked them from power, while the left is celebrating Macron's political gambit. What's your take on tactical voting, and just how often is it used as a political strategy in France?
Now, this is very new. And we are witnessing once again a day in French politics. French politics are never boring. What we have now is a situation where the French people have decided not to support the extreme right. Now, that is not surprising, because coming back to the first round of these elections, it was very clear that there was a message from the people to the government to say, we have had enough. And voting at the time for Jordan Bardella and Marine Le Pen was certainly not a surprise after the European elections. The numbers were. What happened after that was a front being created just for the sake of stopping the Front National from getting succeeding with the election. And that is very unique in French politics. I do not recall this happening in my lifetime, not to that extent anyway. So we now have a situation where the party of Jordan Bardella and Marine Le Pen believes that they were going to win and he would be prime minister. This has not happened, because a front put against them has just not only ensured that they could not succeed, they couldn't come second, but the reality is they're actually going third, which is quite extraordinary there. And the alliance of the left groups, which is made of, it's like a dysfunctional group of rebels from the left, all trying to work together to oppose both Marine Le Pen and also Macron. All this together has managed to succeed. And I think what happened there is that people just did not want Marine Le Pen to succeed. That was a key issue. At time of crisis, French do not go to the right. Historically, they always shift where they feel comfortable. And where they feel comfortable are the parties that are associated with social values, something that Marine Le Pen is not, despite the claims that she made. So that they vote in mass for this alliance of left party, ecologist, communist, Trotskyist, even though they're big words, but that means very little because there's not much in the way of communism in France. But this alliance has stopped that process. What we're going to see now, of course, is confusion. The latest numbers that are just coming as we speak show that this alliance has 182 seats, with perhaps another 13. The party of Emmanuel Macron has a total of 168 with a possible 45 in addition. So we actually seeing them getting very close to each other. And the Rassemblement National, Marine Le Pen, has 143. So 289 seats are required to get a majority. And as we can see, they are a long way away from that.
Talk to me more about that. Of course, the horse trading now begins in earnest. We know a hung parliament and uncertainty loom large there in France. So what do you think the next government will look like?
Well, at this point, we don't know. And no one will find out for days. What is likely to happen is that President Macron will try to get a coalition's to get an assembly that actually works. How can he do this? He can get centrist party, to align with some of the East Republican voices, maybe get a few people from the left who are not necessarily happy with what's happening there, and maybe even a few people from the Rassemblement National. So what he will try to do is to create a coalition that will allow France to function. I have doubts about how this is going to work, because we are now looking at people who just cannot work together. But most of all, their ideologies are very different from one another. So we may have a short-term solution, but that will not give us a prime minister to start with, and second, a functioning parliament.
Another big figure, of course, is President Emmanuel Macron. He rolled the dice on this. He took a gamble. What does it mean for him in terms of policy and politics?
Well, when Macron is a risk taker, Macron is also a technocrat. Macron cares about Macron. One of the key issues at the beginning of this situation was that Marine Le Pen cares about France. Europe comes later. Macron cares about Europe. France comes later. Major difference. And I think the French people have made sure that Macron knew about that. So his options are very limited. There will be some degree of cohabitation, that is, the president with his party, and of course, a prime minister and a government from another party. It has happened before in France, so that's not the major problem. What is difficult for the French to do is to deal with coalitions, simply because they are so entrenched in the way they do things that working with other groups is not necessarily, you know, easy for them. And Macron will have to navigate all this. Prime Minister Attal already offered his resignation. At this point, we don't know, of course, who is going to replace him. He will be acting as a caretaker prime minister, at least because of the Olympics, so that they can ride this wave without the embarrassment of having a political chaos before that. But Macron's hands are very limited. Although looking at the numbers now, he has not done as bad as we thought he would. And you know, Macron is a survivor, and he is very good at making deals. So he may actually find a way to negotiate that situation. But to go against this National Popular Front is going to be incredibly difficult, because the leaders of this front are not going to compromise with him at all. So what we are looking at is possible the possibility of a period of chaos, you know, in French politics until something is actually resolved. But it will take a while for this to happen.
So you're painting a picture of chaos reigning supreme, at least in the short term. Obviously, the right, the ultra-conservatives, will seize on that. What does the future look for that side of politics?
I think the extreme right will be quite upset about it, because they really thought that they were going to succeed. Marine Le Pen has tried many times to either become president or to have one of her members to become head of government. That has not happened. So that is a major slap for her party. But one thing that we must not forget, though, is that this party has doubled on the previous election. So 2 years, twice as many seats. And that is not going to stop. So in a short term, they have been contained, but in the long term, they will continue to grow. And that's a real concern for France.
Associate Professor Jean Bogais, thank you so much for your analysis.
Thank you.